Option one, if it does anything, it only strengthens the argument, saying that it would be easy for the police to catch such cases because it has certain technology, not a weakening statement at all. The conclusion is that number of accidents because of overspeeding will decline. So we need an answer choice that says that this is not going to happen. Habitual offenders will not care. They will continue to overspeed. This is the trap. Quite a few students will mark it. But see, habitual offenders will only be a fraction of the total people who may be overspeeding. And therefore, a decline may still happen. That is why option B is not a very strong weakening choice. This is an interesting choice because see, all of this is being done not to gain revenue out of tickets. It's done to genuinely reduce the cases of accidents. Cases of accidents will reduce when people genuinely stop overspeeding. And this fear of extra fine and all is going to cause that reduction in the cases of overspeeding. But if people underestimate the risk of being caught, then all of this entire argument goes for a toss. And my argument is weakened. This is a fine weakening statement. Let's look at the other ones. This doesn't do much. Whatever rule is being applied, it's going to apply even on empty roads. So this doesn't do much to weaken the argument. C is definitely a lot stronger. Such a thing has happened in past. So this definitely doesn't weaken. If anything, option E also strengthens the argument. And therefore, B, C and D are the three choices which do some bit of weakening. Of the three, C is the strongest.